Hello there, very good morning. You're watching Pro Act of London, and joining us today from NextEnergy Capital is Ross Grier. A warm welcome back, because this morning, of course, you've announced that you've raised your dividend target for an eighth consecutive year, and that's exactly what we're discussing today. So maybe just give us a quick overview of this announcement, if you would, and good to see you.
Great. Yeah, nice to see you as well, Katie. So it's another strong announcement from the NextEnergy Solar Fund. The headlines are: we've increased our dividend target to 7.52 pence per share. That's an industry-leading 5% increase from last year's dividend. It goes above and beyond the 4.1% RPI that we've seen for the 2021 season. And as you've said already, it's NESF's eighth consecutive dividend target increase. We've consistently paid our target dividends since the fund's inception and have paid out more than 250 million in dividends since our IPO. So NESF is a really good income play as part of an investor's diversified portfolio. So it's really exciting to be able to make this announcement today.
All right, and let's just pick up on the fact that the dividend increase was above the retail price index calculation for 2021, the calendar year. Maybe explain to our viewers why a dividend increase like this is so important for them.
So I guess we're all experiencing the current high levels of inflation. Look simply at the bills you have to pay or how much the weekly shop has increased over recent months. And whilst inflation is high, interest rates are remaining really suppressed. So in the face of these higher bills, investors are looking to places to make their money work for them and support the income that they are generating to help them to continue to pay those bills in a way that putting your money in the bank won't. So NESF continues to be a great solution for these investors, especially when we're growing dividend even more than the high levels of RPI being experienced.
Okay, let's talk about how you stack up against your peer group then, because you are now one of the leading companies increasing your dividend within the sector. Maybe just give us a bit of background information to investors about how you've managed to achieve this, really.
Yes, yeah, so that 5% increase really is industry leading, and the solar assets in NESF's portfolio have proven their robustness in consistently outperforming forecasts. It's a message we consistently give to our investors, and we're always publishing that information just so investors can really grasp how consistently that overperformance happens for that portfolio. NESF generates its income from a couple of key sources. Firstly, around 60% of the revenue comes from long-term government-backed and crucially inflation-linked subsidies, and the remainder of revenue comes from selling power into the power markets. Current and upsetting global events led by Russia and pre-existing shortages of gas have led to record highs in those power markets of late. Again, things we're all experiencing at home in paying our electricity bills, and the active power sales strategy that we deploy for NESF manages power price volatility, and where possible allows us to lock in prices above the forecasts that we have for the fund. This therefore creates incremental revenue for NESF, and which we are really proud to be able to share back quickly with investors via the increases in dividend that we've announced.
Mm-hmm. We hear a lot about dividend cover figures. What exactly are these, and how do they offer investors protection?
Yeah, they're definitely a key metric. So put simply, it's the amount of cash generated by our assets divided by the amount of cash we need to pay the dividend. So in short, it's really how secure that dividend picture is out into the future. As we've said already, we have consistently paid our target dividend since inception, and that strengthening power price market and the links we have to inflation give us a really good picture of how the fund is going to perform out into the future before we add the exciting growth prospects that we have as a business as well. So we've got a really good visibility of what's coming over the next few years, and we see a strengthening picture of dividend cover on top of the already strong cover that we achieved for the current financial year.
Okay, you've also mentioned dividend yield. What does this mean exactly, and why is it important for investors?
Yes, it's a simple equation that shows dividend per share divided by a price per share. So it's really showing the percentage of a company's share price that it pays out in that dividend. So you invest 100p in a share and you get 5 pence back, giving you that 5% yield in kind of broad number terms. So when I think about what good looks like in the dividend yield context, I think about what my savings would generate if I simply left them in the bank. So we know at the moment you'd be very lucky to achieve, you know, 1-2% for the money that you tie up in a bank. And in that current world, NESF's 7.2% yield as of close yesterday is a highly attractive proposition, especially when it's more than 1% higher than our peers in the space as well. So we continue as a fund to really try and drive performance as aggressively as we can in order to continue to deliver those outstanding returns to investors.
Mm-hmm. There seems to be plenty of momentum at NextEnergy Solar Fund at the moment. Can you maybe just tell our viewers and your investors what's in the pipeline?
Yes, certainly. So momentum's a great word. I think times are really exciting in NESF. So we've just very recently announced that we've put our latest UK subsidy-free solar farm into construction. The timing of that is crucial because it will come online in the early part of 2023 and therefore benefit from the current power prices that are still anticipated to remain above forecast out into 23 and beyond. In parallel with that, we're advancing well with the construction of our first utility scale battery storage, which is 50 megawatts, a very sizable battery storage. And again, revenues for batteries remain really strong in this market, especially in the face of power price volatility that we've seen over recent months and years. And we see that picture continuing to strengthen out into the future as more renewables come online. We also acquired a minority stake in an international asset in Spain. And we have a really strong and diverse pipeline of growth prospects out into the future. Pairing this, as I've said already, with the existing portfolio's technical and financial performance, NESF remains a great choice for investors and an outstanding buy opportunity as things currently stand.
All right, Ross. Yeah, thank you very much indeed. Great to catch up with us today, discussing, of course, the latest going on there at NextEnergy and just the raising of your dividend target for the 8th consecutive year. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Katie.